Edition of Political Crossfire. This is your host, Al Rogers. We'll have Congressman Bobby Scott calling in any moment now. But and that number again is 561-791-6375. The fiscal crisis continues here in Washington, D.C., as both sides are still not coming to terms to end this shutdown. Now, according to sources that are readily available across the internet, these are the Republicans who have said that they're willing to step across party lines and endorse a further funding of the country for at least 6 to 8 weeks more. Congressman Grayson has a bill, House Bill 3213. We've been told he might be calling in at 12:30, but this is a list of Republicans that have said that they would support this. Pat Meehan of Pennsylvania, Scott Riggle of Virginia, John Runyon of New Jersey, Mike Fitzpatrick of Pennsylvania, Peter King of New York, and there's another 14 other ones besides that. And of course, Mary D. S. Ballard is the only Floridian on that list of 19 House Republicans that have said they would come and force to come across party lines and endorse a stoppage of the fiscal crisis we now are embroiled in. Now, what are some of the federal employees doing during the shutdown? The law, at least, the Justice Department's interpretation contains exemptions for several classes of employees. The biggest exemption is employees necessary to protect the public health, safety, or property. Now, 6,000 NSA officers were sent away a week ago. Many of them have been asked to return after 1 week of furlough. But we're going to hit another bump in the road come October 17th. And as I was saying, the exemption for employees, you got government data employees that are doing research experiments. Those things we postpone. Political appointees are exempt because they cannot be placed on leave by law. Now, who decides which employees go back and go to work and which come home? The office manager and budget and office of personnel management control a lot of that. Now, there was in the news that some tourists out in a federal park. I don't have that in front of me, the exact news event, but it was discussed earlier on the radio, and I was trying to pull it up just prior to the show, and I could not, but apparently the Park Service employees held tourists at bay from entering Yellowstone Park. The first thing we're gonna pull up here is the explanation by of Congressman Grayson on the Fiscal Act of 2013. Now, the difference between this and what they might pass is this would postpone it one entire year to next October, and that's Yeah, we have Congressman Bobby Scott calling in.
Hello, you. Congressman, you ready?
All right, thanks. Okay, I'm going to stall the Grayson thing until later.
Press line one.
Welcome back, Congressman Scott. Glad for you to join us today. I was saying earlier that there are 19 House Republicans that have announced that they would be willing to come across. Some of them are including Pat Meehan of Pennsylvania, Scott Riggle of Virginia, John Runyon of New Jersey, Mike Fitzpatrick, Peter King, Rob Willman, and the list goes on. I have an entire list of 19 that have said they would vote for a short-term, six-week...
That's short-term continuing resolution to keep the government open for 6 weeks is all we're talking about right now.
Yeah.
And the ones you've mentioned, and I think the list is actually into the 20s, but the problem is the Speaker won't bring it up, and when we offer motions to bring it up, notwithstanding the fact the Speaker doesn't want to bring it up, all of those Republicans vote with the Speaker to enable him to keep it off the floor. And I don't think there's any question that there'd be votes to reopen the government, but they just keep voting with the Republicans, so they walk around with some halo of moderation about what they're talking about, but they won't vote. We don't need their press releases. We need their votes.
Right.
And if only one or two of them would break, then I think we could get the bill to the floor. The problem with the shutdown is that we're not really in a reality-based world. The Republicans believe that Obamacare is a threat to democracy as we know it, and if they stay the course, they'll repeal it.
Yeah, well, see, let me just interject there. The insurance industry is paying almost $6 million per congressman to, if you average that over the entire 435, to push this shutdown forward. And several of your colleagues have said on other broadcasts, like the Tom Hartman Show and on MSNBC, this whole thing is concocted to, they're basically pleasing their contributors by stalling this as long as it came out. One question before you go on about what you're about to say is, some of the names I just mentioned said they would come across their aisle to vote for, are those names that I mentioned, like Mario Diaz-Balart, Paul Meehan, Scott Riggle of Virginia, are they also voting to allow the vote to stay off the floor?
They're voting with the Speaker to keep the motion off the floor. The only way, there are procedural ways that we can force a vote, but you can't do it without a majority vote. And if they have the majority, then you need some of them to actually vote with the Democrats to bring it to the floor. Now, sometimes it gets a little convoluted. We'll offer an amendment to a bill to open up the whole government. The Speaker will say it's not germane, and then we challenge the ruling of the chair. They vote with the Speaker. If they would vote with us, we could put it in order, put it on the floor, and the next order of business would be to vote on it.
Huh.
But we can't, without a majority, we can't do that, and they vote with the Republicans against us trying to make such a motion in order. So when they talk about they'd be willing to vote, sure, they'd be willing to, if the Speaker would bring it to the floor, then they vote to keep the to empower the Speaker to keep it off the floor.
Yes,
it's a tough vote to vote against your party on a procedural matter, but you can't get to the substance until you've done the procedure.
Yeah, see, the thing is that out of the 19 that have come publicly to say they would break ranks, three of them are sitting in your state of Virginia.
And none of them have voted with the. All of them have voted right down the line with the Speaker. I mean, you look at the votes that have been cast over the last 2 weeks. The vote of those 19 has been indistinguishable from from the votes that Michelle Bachmann has cast.
Yeah,